What about your HIPAA authorization? HIPAA stands for Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act. And that was a very well-intentioned piece of legislation. But one part of it, it was intended to help preserve your privacy. And it does preserve your privacy more than you want it to, even, because it means that medical providers are sometimes reluctant to disclose your information to someone you might want to have it, like a spouse, because of the criminal penalties involved if they violate HIPAA. With a HIPAA authorization, you're designating others to allow them to get medical information from medical providers. You're allowing the medical providers to disclose to them. The HIPAA authorization is a little bit different from the medical power of attorney. Remember that the medical power of attorney, number one, it's giving someone permission to make decisions for you. And number two, it only applies if you're incapacitated. The HIPAA authorization is saying, doctor, you can disclose information to this person, and it's effective even if you're not incapacitated. When might this be useful? Let's say that you have just undergone a procedure and you're woozy, and your spouse and family members want to know how you're doing, or you've gone home from the procedure and now it looks like you're having some sort of adverse reaction and your spouse is calling the doctor's office saying, look, this is happening, what should I do? You want to have that HIPAA authorization in place so the medical provider doesn't say, well, I'd like to tell you, but I can't because that's health information that's privileged and I can't share it with you. You have the HIPAA authorization that you provide to your medical person, and it says, medical provider, you can go ahead and disclose information to these persons. Okay?